Thank you.
Tread softly, stranger, whatever you do. Tread softly, stranger, that's my plea to you. 'Cause I'm telling you, stranger, my heart's
in danger. Linda, darling. Hello, Johnny. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you.
Come sit down. Now, what'll you drink?
Don't remember.
Oh, of course, Scotch on the Rocks, I'd forgotten. Well, take your things off.
Your coat, I mean.
It's been a long time.
It's been too long.
Last.
That you, Johnny?
Oh, hello, Bill.
Tonight's the night. You owe me a lot of money, and if I don't collect, you'd better get yourself a good plastic surgeon.
I've got the money, Bill. I'll bring it round.
You wouldn't be kidding, Johnny.
No, I'll drop it by first thing in the morning.
Johnny, what are you doing? Is anything wrong?
Well, I owe this gentleman a little bit of money. And just at the moment, I haven't enough to pay.
Well,
inclined to become a little impatient.
So, if I can get out of London as quickly as I can.
Oh, but Johnny.
Not just at the minute, honey.
Where are you going?
Home.
It for good when I was just a kid. Somehow when you're in trouble, to lie low for a while. The town you were born in seems the safest place.
Good shot.
Well, let's see if we can get that pink in over there.
Serve that black in that pocket over there.
Well, I'll be Johnny, my boy.
Ryan, my old pal.
Johnny, how are you?
Mr. Ryan.
Great to see you.
Joe, you're a sight for sore eyes and no mistake.
Well, Dave never let on you were coming.
He didn't even know. You still at the foundry, Joe?
Yeah, sure, night watchman. Where else would I be? Sure, it's Mallaby's for all of us. Me, Paddy, and Dave, too.
Dave?
Oh, no, no, he's got a good enough job. He's in the office. But didn't you know?
We've been a bit out of touch this last 10 years. I was hoping to find him in here.
Not these days. Dave has got a regular now.
Dave's got a regular? What's she like?
Oh, she's a looker.
She's no good. She works in that dance place.
Flo's Club, 3 times a week. Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays.
What's she do the rest of the week?
Well, you better ask Dave about that.
I will when I catch him up. Where does he live now?
Widow Finnegan's, 37 Scunthorpe Road.
37 Scunthorpe Road.
Tell me, son. Why in heaven's name did you leave a beautiful place like London to come to this heap of cinders and clinkers, huh?
It's a long story, Joe. I'll tell you some other time. Do give you 2 black stars.
Oh, we'll see about that.
So long, Paddy.
So long.
He's a smart fella, Johnny.
I wonder.
Dave Mansell, live here.
He's not back yet.
I'm his brother. Mind if I go up to his room and wait for him?
Can if you want to. There's nothing worth taking.
Oh, where is it?
Top floor back. Turn right at the top of the stairs and follow your nose.
Door locked?
Why should it be? I'm here, aren't I?
You might be thinking of taking a room.
How long for?
Don't know yet.
There's one next to him vacant.
How much?
30 bob a week in advance. If you don't mind.
I'll take it.
Don't you want to see it first?
If I did, I probably wouldn't take it, would I?
You're someone else.
I wish I was.
Have you just moved in?
Yeah.
That's nice. I live just over there, so we'll be neighbors.
Dave's girlfriend.
I'm a friend of his. Why?
I'm his brother.
So you're Johnny. Famous Johnny. Well, I've heard a lot about you.
In a short space of time, I've heard quite a bit about you.
Really?
I hear we might be related, you and I.
I said I was a friend of Dave's, that's all.
Good. I like it better that way.
And what does that mean?
Just making conversation?
You have a very funny line of talk, Mr. Mansell.
I thought we'd understand one another.
I'm easy to understand.
Then you're not as feminine as you look. What's your name?
Calico.
Calico?
It's a nickname.
Funny thing about women in men's jerseys. Makes them look more like women than ever. What are you doing in a place like this?
Romance. He left and I stayed.
Where's your home?
That's funny. I never had one.
Johnny! Johnny, where are you?
I'm out here. In the garden.
Johnny! Johnny, this is wonderful. When Matt Finnegan told me, I couldn't believe it.
Been a long time, hasn't it?
You look terrific.
You don't look so bad yourself.
Don't I? Well, don't go, Calico. This is Johnny.
Yeah, we met.
Oh, what's the hurry?
Look, this is Brother's Day. I don't want to intrude. I'll see you later.
All right. I'll bring Johnny over. It's grand to see you, Johnny. Oh, blast. Oh, I'll drop it in later. Come and tell me all about yourself.
Can you afford her?
Oh, you're wrong, Johnny. She's not like that. It's possible.
Thanks for the roses, Dave.
Mind the thorns. Want to dance?
I'm not paid to dance here. I just help run the place.
So?
I want you to know, that's all. When I dance, I do it for pleasure.
Do you mind, Dave?
No, go ahead. I'm going to have another drink.
You like dancing?
I like dancing with you.
How long are you going to stay here in Rawborough?
I don't know.
It's not like London, is it? What made you come back here?
It's a second-rate place. I'm a second-rater.
That's not what Dave says. He says you were doing fine. What happened?
Long row of losers. 300 at Lincoln. 500 at Ascot. Didn't have enough wool on my back to cover myself. If I hadn't left quietly, I would have had a civic send-off. Every bookmaker in town was after my blood. Is that watch genuine?
Maybe.
Hiya, Dave. Two whiskies.
Hello. Who's Calico got her hooks into now?
Johnny Mansell from London.
You don't waste any time, that girl.
He'll handle her all right.
I wouldn't mind handling her myself.
That's not for you. Dave's keeping it in the family, aren't you, Dave?
Too bad. I could do with a drink, though.
Whiskey.
An expensive taste, Dave. You must be in the money.
In the money? What do you mean by that?
Nothing. Who's a jumpy, Dave? Must be an expensive thing having a girl like Calico.
Well, I like to give her a good time. Who wouldn't?
You in love with her?
I suppose so. It gives me a kick to buy her things.
Like the watch, for instance. It's a nice job.
Worth a bit, too.
I got it cheap.
How cheap?
How much do you make at Mallaby's? £12 a week.
£12 a week? That's nothing. Still, who am I to talk?
You broke, Johnny.
Oh, I'll get along.
There might be a job at Mallaby's.
Doing what?
Bookkeeping.
Bookkeeping? Have you said bookmaking?
If you need a bit to go on with, I might be able to borrow it.
Where from?
Well, I could perhaps get it for you. I don't know offhand.
No, thanks, Dave. I think you've got your own problems. Well, I think I'll go to bed. Good night.
Night, Johnny.
Spending it.
Oh, Paddy, I know we're going to get married, but it doesn't mean to say we have to live like hermits. It'll be the first time for a week.
Oh, yes, you're right. Now you run along before old Potter gets out.
You were miles away. I know what it is. Too many late nights down at the club.
Very good, sir. Now, Miss Parsons, will you tell them downstairs I've got to have those clock cards at once and no argument about it?
Oh, it's all right, Mr. Potter. I've got them here.
Oh, good. Then we can get on. We've got the auditors coming on Monday week and we must be ready. Oh, these clock cards are always the same. We'll never have the books ready at this rate. I'm afraid this means weekend work for you and me, Mansell. And you, Fletcher.
Afternoon, Flo.
Well?
Can I use your phone? Business, of course.
Thanks for asking.
That's a nice hat, Flo.
You like it?
Yes. That reminds me. There's a horse running in the 2 o'clock. Spring chicken.
Do you mind?
Hello, Jim. Johnny Mansell. Can you put me a tenner on Rest Assured in the 2 o'clock?
And no more fights while I've gone.
That's right. And 2 bob each way on spring chicken. Yeah, bye. Hello. What are you doing here?
I work here, remember?
What are you
you staring at me for?
Just wondering.
Wondering what?
The old lady tried to bring us up good. She was only that high, but she thought we were wonderful.
She couldn't be wrong, of course.
Ma thought I was the responsible one. Dave was always nervy. She reckoned he'd get into trouble if she left him alone.
Why are you telling me all this?
When she died, she asked me to keep an eye on him. You know, help him.
You being the smart one, of course. Why don't you just tell me what's on your mind?
Just play the game with Dave.
Why shouldn't I?
You know how it is. Some women are mercenary.
So are some men. He can look after himself.
He's blinded by you, Kaneko. He's not your style. He can't give you the life you're hungry for.
Can you?
I've no diamond watches up my sleeve.
Johnny, are you going to look for a job now that you're back? There's plenty of work about.
Why bring up a painful subject? I'm self-employed. I let the horses do it for me. I won a cool 50 yesterday.
50 pounds? Gosh, Paddy, we could almost buy that bedroom suite on that.
The Moonraker looks a good thing next week.
Oh, no, thanks, Johnny. I'll do it the hard way. I'm on night shift next week.
Good, that'll keep you out of mischief.
Oh, we're supposed to be celebrating. What's wrong, Dave?
Nothing's wrong.
Oh, yes, there is. You're a misery. What is it?
Why don't you mind your own damn business and leave me alone?
Well, Johnny, we'd better be going.
Sorry about that. You never know with Dave. One day's all right, the next day's got a sore tail. One day's so mean he won't give you the time, the next day he'll give you all he's got.
Yes, I know what you mean. Never mind. Do you want me to ask about a job for you at the foundry?
No, thanks, Paddy. Goodbye, Sylvia.
Goodbye.
Nice to have met you.
Thanks, Johnny.
Come on. Let's have it.
You bury your head in your racing papers all day, and where does it get you except...
Listen, you're in a jam. Now tell it fast.
Take your hands off me.
Dave, for Pete's sake, what's wrong?
Like you said, Johnny, I'm in a jam. I'm in trouble up to the neck. I've been taking money from Malaby's.
You've what?
They're coming to do the books Monday week.
How much?
£300.
Any of it left? No. It all went on Calico. Her in the moonlight. Big eyes and lazy, drawling voice. She's got you by the short hairs. One hand in your knee and the other in your pocket.
Don't come that big brother
at me. Bloody fool, didn't you know that you were going to be caught? You'll go to jail for this. Well, I hope you had your money's worth.
Johnny, you've got to help me.
Help you? Where am I going to get £300 from?
Well, don't look at me. I didn't know there was that much money.
I am looking at you. He needs that money.
Why me? I haven't got any.
You've got the watch he gave you.
I haven't got it. It broke. It's being repaired.
Get it back.
You must get it.
Why?
Because he borrowed £300 from Malaby's.
I stole it. I stole it out of the wages money and I faked the books.
And he spent it on you.
I didn't ask him to steal for me.
Not above a whisper.
I'm not blaming you, Calico. It was my own fault.
He's got 8 days to put it back.
Well?
You can give him back his watch for a start.
All right, let him have it if he wants it. I don't care. It's not worth more than 100 secondhand.
How do you know?
Because a fellow I know told me that's what it was worth. Anyway, why don't you do something instead of standing around just looking smart?
What, for instance? Break into Malaby's?
Put you straight with your bookmaking friends, too.
It could be done, Johnny.
Dave's got just 8 days, hasn't he?
before anyone finds out that his books don't tally with the cash. Supposing someone were to break into the place the night before payday and take the lot. It wouldn't matter then about the books, would it? Because no one would ever know.
It would be easy. They bring the wages in Thursday, the money's in the safe all night. We could go over the roof, drop through the skylight, come out when they change shifts.
Do you think you could do it?
With Johnny, I could.
You're crazy, the pair of you. We're amateurs. We'd be caught. I'll stretch a point if there's money in it. But just so far. I'd do it if I thought it would help. But you're in it too deep. Can't you see that?
I don't know, Johnny. I don't know. Looks like I'm caught anyway. I'm going out. I can't breathe in here.
Thanks. You've been a fine help.
Look who's talking. You. Why, you wouldn't even lift a finger to help him. Your own brother. If he is your brother.
Shut up!
At least he had the guts to take what he wanted. Not like you. You're just yellow.
Mansell.
Hello, Mr. Potter.
You're not looking too well. What's getting you down?
I'm all right, Mr. Potter.
Can't have you going sick on me. Got to get those books straight, and it's Wednesday already.
Yes, Mr. Potter.
It's all up, Johnny. Potter caught me up on the way home, talked about getting the books straight.
Well, don't panic. That's not going to do any good. I've got £40 here.
40? I've got to have it all by the weekend.
There's a horse running at 3:30 tomorrow. It's a cert. I know the owner. He hasn't sent it all the way up here just for the exercise.
You get that watch from Calico.
That's worth £80. That's £120 to play with. Racetracks aren't very healthy for me at the moment, but I'll have to try it. Might even win enough to get you straight.
Supposing it loses?
It's a cert, I tell you. I'll leave early tomorrow morning. I'll be back 7 o'clock latest.
All right, Johnny. Thanks. I better see Calico now.
He's gone to the club.
You coming?
Wouldn't miss this for the world.
Giving you the watch, aren't I? On second thoughts, there you are.
It's not for me, you know.
Then I ask him to do what he did.
No, not you.
True, don't take it out on me.
Nobody gets anything out of you. Not without a hammer and chisel.
Oh, go and lose it on a horse.
Hello, son.
Hello, Dad.
Waiting for me or Sylvia?
Now, who do you think it would be?
I don't approve of men waiting on women, son, but a girl like Sylvia is worth waiting for.
Hello, Paddy. Hello, Dad.
Lizzie.
Oh, I must hurry. I'm late.
See you tonight. We've got 2 hours together.
Yes, of course, but I'm fed up with this night shift business. You work all night and I work all day.
We'll soon put a stop to it. I'll not have my wife working.
Well, that's an old-fashioned idea, but then I'm an old-fashioned girl. Goodbye.
Bye. She's a great girl. I'm glad, Pat, you're going to marry her. Do you know, son, I'm looking forward to the breakfast she'll cook.
Well, there's something in that, Dad. Well, I'm going to see Charlie up in the high street. He's fixing us up with a new valve for the TV. Bye, Dad.
See you later, son.
£50.
£50? Cost 200.
What do you think I am? Benevolent Society? 70.
Make it 80 with the glasses.
I don't need the glasses.
You can't see the watch is worth more than 70. You need the glasses.
Name, address.
Mansell. 37 Scunthorpe Road.
Sign there. 10, 20, 40, 60, 70.
Well, up early this morning, Johnny.
Hello, hello. You hawking something?
Not at all. Just getting these out. Going racing.
We'll have you working yet.
Not if I can help it, you won't. Johnny back?
Of course he's not back.
He's late. What kind of happened?
What do you think? He's walked out on us. That's what's happened. Sold my watch and probably celebrating in London by now.
Calico.
He's cheated on us.
No, not Johnny. Something must have happened to him.
No, no, not to Johnny. He's too smart.
What shall I do?
I don't care what you do. He's your brother, not mine.
Tonight's the last chance.
The last chance for what?
Breaking into the foundry.
How much is there?
In our office, 6,000.
6,000? That's a lot of money. Could you do it?
I don't know.
Dave, it'd be easy for you. You know your way around. Just think, we could go away together. We could go to Paris, Italy, all the places I've ever wanted to see. Couldn't you do it?
He'll be back on the 9 o'clock.
He won't be back. He's walked out on us. Don't you understand that?
Are you all right, old man?
Took a bit of a bashing, didn't I?
Easy now, easy.
Still, they didn't get this.
He'll be all right, just keep him quiet. These GGs don't half kick, eh, chum?
Yeah.
Are you preferring any charges?
Charges? No, just an argument with some of the boys up from London.
The nice straight left thrown in.
Well, you know how it is.
Yes. There's no charge at all, isn't it? Take a tip. Keep away from this race course. We don't like smart gents around here.
Okay, okay, Chief. What's the time?
Just after 7.
Where's that train?
Is it 8:30 from London?
That's no good.
Nine, he's not back.
And he won't be. There's no way out, Dave. You're on your own.
If I did it, would you really come away with me, marry me?
Yes, of course.
But what if it goes wrong?
It can't go wrong, just as long as you keep calm. It's better than going to jail, isn't it? You've got everything to gain and nothing to lose. It's now or never, Dave. The night shift will be coming off at any moment. Here, take that.
Where did you get it?
Oh, it's a souvenir from some fellow I knew in the army. You don't have to use it, just take it. It'll give you confidence. Now use the fire escape, then Ma Finnegan won't know you've been out.
Thank you.
my mate. Thanks for the lift.
Now, jump.
Dave.
What happened?
Well, I won Dave's 300 and 150 fun money.
450?
Where's Dave Calico?
What's the matter with your head?
Nothing. Met some old friends. Got a crack on the head. I said, where's Dave?
You better take a rest. He'll be back soon.
Back? Where from? He's gone to Malabis. That's what you're hiding. You sent him there, you dirty little wharf rat. When did he go?
Just before you came. Johnny, what are you gonna do?
Stop him.
No, it's too late. Johnny, please believe me. I thought you'd walked out on us, and I got mad, and I thought I was never gonna see you again. I didn't care what happened after that. Oh, Johnny, please listen to me. I didn't know what I was doing, honestly. Johnny!
Explain everything, Mr. Ryan, but...
Johnny Monson. And Dave, too. You'll have to explain to the police. Come on.
Dave!
You're out of it, Johnny!
So it's come to this, has it? A spiv with a gun.
I'll use it, Joe. Keep away from me.
Keep away, Joe.
Joe! Get back!
Stay where you are, Joe!
You can't frighten me, Dave!
Joe!
Give back that money! Give back that money!
You have killed him.
Let's get out. Come on.
Johnny, what's the use?
Who was he?
Don't know, never saw him before.
Oh, come on. Keep down.
What's the use, Johnny?
Come on.
that gun.
Come on.
Where'd you get it from?
Calico gave it me. Calico, I thought as much. Come on, get up.
What happened?
There was an accident. Old Joe Ryan. The gun went off and...
He's dead.
Old man Ryan. Fool, what did you kill him for?
I didn't mean to. I swear I didn't. I only meant to frighten him.
What's the difference? If we get caught, we're both for it.
Johnny, that old man, he'll give us away.
What old man?
There was an old fellow with Ryan.
We were so near him, he'd know us anywhere.
Oh, it was pretty dark in that passage. I'll know him, all right. I'd never forget his face.
What have you done with the gun?
Throw it in the canal. Murder and armed robbery. I told you not to touch that money. I'd got it. I'd won enough. More than we needed. Do you understand?
It's too late now, Johnny.
He did it for you, you tramp. What would he want with all this money? You put him up to it!
Don't touch her!
He wouldn't have done it for anybody on God's earth but you!
He didn't do it for me. He did it to get me. And that's a very different thing.
What are you doing?
Getting out, of course. Me and Calico.
You're not going anywhere, either of you.
Yes, we are.
Now, you listen to me. We're sticking together. You too.
Me?
Yes, you.
We're murderers.
Don't you understand? We'll give ourselves away by running for it. Where would we go? Who'd hide us?
He's right, Dave.
We've got to stay here. We've got to act as if nothing had happened. God, I wish it never had.
I got you into this, Johnny. If they catch us, I'll tell them how you tried to stop me.
They'd never believe you. Look, you better try and get some sleep. You mustn't look too bad when you get into the office tomorrow.
Office?
Yes. Office.
I can't go to that office.
Don't you understand? You've got to go. It doesn't matter about the books not balancing anymore. What is important is that you've got to behave as if you didn't know anything. It's our only chance.
All right, Johnny. That's what you think.
I'll look after the money.
There's no pay packet this week, Tom.
What?
We had visitors last night. Got away with the wages.
Oh.
Aye, cleared out the safe.
I wish I'd thought of that.
They did old Ryan in.
Johnson.
Sorry, I didn't know.
That's all right, Mansell. You've heard the news?
Yes, they just told me, sir.
This is Dave Mansell, one of my best clerks.
Did you know Ryan?
Yes, I knew him since I was a kid.
Well, I have some questions to ask you later.
The rest of the staff are in the other room, Mansell. Wait there with them, will you?
Right.
If only there were some fingerprints.
Now, come on, let's get on with it. No visitors?
No. Look, can't I go and get dressed now? I've been out here for hours.
Look, you've been on this roof for weeks practicing your exercises. Dave can go to the office as usual. You can do your exercises. It's not much to ask.
But I...
Shut up and let me read this.
I'm cold.
That's funny. The old boy who saw us has disappeared.
Disappeared?
Maybe he shouldn't have been there. Maybe he's frightened. They might think it was him. And how did they know he was there? I don't get it. One thing. I was right. I'll just have to sweat it out.
Hello, Paddy. It's nice of you to meet me.
Hello, Dave. Hello, Paddy. I'm sorry about your father.
Terrible.
I'd just like to get my hands on whoever it was that did it.
Do you know anything yet?
No. What sort of a person could he be who'd murder an old man like he was? Dave, do you remember how he used to play with us for hours when we were kids?
I shouldn't think they meant to do it.
Well, they had a gun, didn't they?
Dave, do you remember an old boy called Danny?
No, I don't think so.
He used to keep Dad company every night. He was with him again yesterday. He must have been there when Dad was... Well, when Dad was murdered.
Now he's vanished.
You think he did it?
No. No, whoever it was, it wasn't him. No, there's only one conclusion I can draw. I think that the murderers took him away.
No.
Why not?
Well, I mean, how could they?
Well, they could kidnap him.
Kidnap him?
I'm sure it was no one from around here.
And I'm sure it was an inside job.
Why'd you say that?
It stands to reason. If he'd been a stranger in the place, he'd have tied him up, beaten him up. But he would not have murdered him. Look, the man that killed him because he had to stop his mouth forever.
Who do you think it was?
Well, who do you think it was?
Me? Why?
Well, we go this way. Goodbye, Dave.
Bye.
Quiet! Now, what are you shouting about?
The old man, the one in the corridor. I've seen him.
When did you see him?
Just now. I just left Paddy Ryan when I saw the old man.
You can't have. He's disappeared. It's in the evening papers.
That's what Paddy Ryan said, but I tell you, I saw him a couple of minutes ago.
Easy, Dave. You're getting the jitters. What did Ryan say? That's important.
Do you think I'm drunk? It's a trick, Johnny. They're trying to trick us.
Pull yourself together. What did Ryan say?
He said the old man had been kidnapped.
Well, then he doesn't suspect us. How does he know?
Johnny, I can't keep going to that office. Just sitting there where it happened.
You've got to. Every day as usual. That way you'll live. Otherwise, they'll be on us.
I can't, Johnny, I can't.
You can, and you will.
Why don't you have a lie down, Dave? The rest will do you good, huh? Do you think he's going off his head?
If he does, we're all sunk. He'll collapse and give the whole game away.
He hasn't got much guts, has he?
You didn't see old man Ryan die, did you?
dreamt I saw him again, Johnny.
You saw nothing. Here, drink this. Come on. Let's get you to bed. I'll get some sleep.
You see, Calico gave me the gun. I love her. Can't stop loving her. She doesn't love me, she never did.
Never loved anybody that girl but herself.
She loves you, Johnny.
Crazy.
You're in love with her, too.
I said, you're crazy. So I get some sleep. Take it easy, Dave. Shan't be long.
Time like this, he sits reading a book.
It's a remarkable book, Calico. It's a Bible.
About 10, I'd say. I had the wireless on low when the play just ended. I could look at the Radio Times if you like, but I'm pretty sure it was about 10, because I distinctly remember.
That's himself just went out. Shall I fetch him back?
No. Thanks for all your trouble, Mrs. Finnegan.
Wait, keep calm. Business as usual, he says.
He's a cool one, that Johnny.
No, not really. Inside, he's just as scared as we are. How much longer have we got to wait? If they'd arrested us straight away, I could have taken it, but this... I don't understand. 3 days and nothing happened.
You in a hurry to get arrested? The old man's gone. The paper said so.
Don't believe it. They're just trying...
Good morning.
Morning, Mr. Holroyd.
Morning.
It's another lovely day, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Any more news about the murder?
No.
Ah, you know, really. Eh? Fat as butter.
He's cute, isn't he?
Soft, too, just like velvet.
A calico, you mean?
Oh, Mr. Holroyd.
No, just my phone.
What's his name?
Oh, he doesn't have no name. You don't want to get soppy over rabbits. Now think of the city juggins. Locked up here all his life. Quiet and peaceful, he sits there. He doesn't know what's in store for him. One of these days, I'll be coming along. And then...
Oh, don't. It's horrible.
Horrible note. Make a lovely meal, won't you? Would you like me to save you a bit?
No, thank you. I couldn't touch any.
Oh, please yourself. Do all the more for me, won't they, beauty? Aye, then he goes. But here he comes not back.
Do you think he said that on purpose?
Of course he didn't.
Perhaps he knows. They all know, the police, everybody, they're just waiting for...
Stop it! Stop it! I can't take any more! What's he done with that money?
It's in the cupboard.
Get it out.
It's locked. He's got the key.
It doesn't matter. Get a knife, anything. Quickly. We're gonna get out of here. If Johnny wants to stay, then let him.
Two up to.
Nothing.
Weren't expecting anyone, that's all.
Well, I had to see Ma Finnegan, so, well, I thought I'd pop in.
Well, come in.
Thanks. I won't stay long. Well, do you need some help?
No, that's all right. I can manage.
Mm. Oh, your lock's broken. Heavy, isn't it? Oh. What's this?
Just some string. I was trying to tie it up with it. It's only some old shoes.
Shoes?
Any news about your father, Manny?
No, not a word. Dad killed. Danny vanished from the face of the earth. I just don't know what the police are up to. This tied here for you. There we are.
Thank you.
Oh, I've been making a few inquiries on my own at Mallaby's and roundabouts. It's all I can do. Asking people where they were that night. Some say they don't even remember.
I was home all evening. I got back early and Calico came over and we had a few drinks, didn't we,
oh,
Calico?
Yes, we were together until midnight. You know how it is when you get talking.
Yes, indeed I do. I was wondering, Dave, would Johnny have been with you all that time?
Johnny, why?
What about Johnny?
Well, I was just asking Dave if he knew where you were the night my father was murdered.
Well, you can ask me yourself now, can't you?
Oh, all right, I will. Where were you?
Here most of the time. Not the early part. I went racing. Do you remember?
That's right.
We met on the way to the station. Won a packet. Hence the loot. I got back about, what time was it, Dave? About 10.
That's right. You can ask Mrs. Finnegan.
He's already done that. Haven't you, Paddy?
Yes, I did. She also said you went out again a few minutes later.
What's it got to do with you? Quiet, Dave. Don't get upset. I suppose you want to know where I went.
Well, if you don't mind, Johnny.
I don't mind if they don't mind. Well, Paddy's broad-minded. When I came back, Dave and Calico were busy. So I slipped down to the grapes for a drink.
You see anyone you knew?
Didn't go inside. Suddenly thought I'd like a spot of fresh air. I'd met some chums up from London, had a bit of a dust up on the race course. Got a bang on the head. It's a long story, but you can check up on it.
So what'd you do?
Went for a walk. Didn't see anybody I knew. It's not much of an alibi, is it?
Well, I've heard better.
You'll be accusing me next.
Well, how could you have done it? You were with Dave all the time, talking.
What's all this checking up for? Why don't you stop hinting and come out with it?
Shut up, Dave. Paddy. Dave's a sensitive type. I'm not. I'd still like to know who you thought did it.
Oh, Johnny, believe me, I don't know. That's the holy truth. Oh, the police are doing all they can to find out, and I'm trying to help them. It's all I can do. You blame me?
No, I don't, Paddy.
The questions I've asked you and Dave are the same I've been asking everyone. I just didn't know Dave would take it so badly. Well, I'm sorry I troubled you, Johnny.
That's all right. Drop in any time.
Thanks, I will. Well, I'll be on my way now. See you again.
What'd you have to shoot your big mouth off for?
He knows it was us, Johnny. He knows.
He knows nothing. Neither do the police. Otherwise, they would have taken us days ago. Come on. Let's have a drink. You bloody fools. Man might have caught you. What do you think you're doing?
I wanted some money to buy a new dress.
Don't kid me. I told you I'd look after the money. Thank you.
Hello, Flo. Rough night?
As usual.
Oh, here.
Oh, sorry, son, I can't do it.
Why not?
The governor's orders. You're too lucky. Broke his bleeding heart. Well, leastways, you would have done if he'd had one.
Whiskey, please, Len. One for Flo.
I've got to check the numbers. It's the robbery at the works last Thursday. The police are checking up.
Well, don't smudge it. I only made it this morning. See you later, Len. Just dropped in for a quick one.
Body beautiful.
So funny.
Men? I always think men look funny when they shave.
Seen many?
Maybe. You know I'm in love with you, don't you?
You're in great humor today. Unfortunately, I'm not.
Not in love with me?
Not in a good humor. Or, for that matter, in love with you. Why don't you go back to your room? Like a little privacy.
Because I hate being by myself. I don't sleep. I mean it, you know.
Mean what?
I'm in love with you.
Like you meant it with Dave.
I never said I was in love with Dave, because I wasn't.
He paid top prices. I don't. That's the difference.
I'm not for sale, Johnny. I never was.
No? I don't want any part of you.
Oh, yes, you do.
Get out.
You know you don't really want me to go.
Stop staring at me.
I love you, Johnny.
First Dave, now me.
Nothing down here, sir.
All right, try further upstream.
What are they doing?
Looking for some hardware. Gun, as a matter of fact.
Hello, PL2X calling PX-18. Are you receiving me? Search for murder weapons till I'm successful.
Someone came for you.
Who was it?
An old fella, a cripple he was, and he had a beard. He didn't say his name, and I didn't ask him. He's gone now.
You thought I was drunk when I said I'd seen the old man, didn't you? Didn't you? Well, he's been here. He was asking for me a few minutes ago.
There's been nobody here all day.
It was him, I tell you, and he'll come back.
Take a grip on yourself. The old man's face is getting on your nerves.
And they're fishing for the gun in the canal.
What are you saying?
We've got to make a run for it. Really make a run this time. We've got the money.
Now, you listen to me.
I'm not taking any more orders from you. I'm going.
Johnny, we've got to get away.
All right. You go if you want to. That's what they're waiting for. If they had any real proof, they would have arrested us days ago.
That's what you say. It's a chance and I'm taking it. You stay here if you want to and keep your share of the money.
There is no money.
What did you say? Where is it? What have you done with it?
I burnt it.
Johnny.
You've done what?
It's the only thing to do. The police have got the numbers.
You're lying.
I had to get rid of it. They're even checking the numbers at the pub. Put it all into the sink and I set fire to it.
It's halfway down the sewers by now.
But what about the money you won?
What do you think we've been living on?
Then it's all been for nothing.
You've no right to burn it. No right. It was my money. Mine. I killed for it. Killed for it. I'll kill you.
Dave, stop it. Stop it.
This is a private fight. Well, may the Irish join in.
It's a private one. But it'll keep. What do you want?
Well, I heard the noise and...
Come to spy on us, have you?
No, you're wrong, Dave. I came up to tell you that we're neighbors now.
Neighbors?
Sort of. I've got a surprise for you. Sylvia. Sylvia's moved in.
Here?
I'm just across the landing.
What for? Oh, sorry, Sylvia, that sounds rude, doesn't it? But what I mean is, well, what for?
Well, Paddy's lonely in the house now, and so I thought I'd move into town. And where better than here?
I hope we didn't choose the wrong moment. We've come to tell you that we've arranged a little celebration.
Wedding bells, huh? Are we invited?
Invited? You're going to be the guests of honor.
What do you mean?
I think we know who killed my father.
Then why don't the police arrest them?
Well, they will any moment now. There's just one little bit of evidence they need, and then... Well, then, you know what happens.
What happens?
Why, a little celebration. Very quiet, of course.
Leave us alone! Get out!
Shut up, Dave.
Dave.
Do you mind, Paddy?
Come on, Paddy. Dave's not himself today.
You won't forget to come to our little party, will you? Wouldn't be the same without you.
Johnny. Johnny, I'm frightened. Take me away.
Where, for instance?
We could hide.
Yes, for a day or two, perhaps. No, Calico, we've got to call their bluff.
Do you think Ryan's bluffing the way he's acting?
I think he's playing a hunch. I think he suspects us. They can't do anything without the old man. And I think he's dead. Well, I think he's dead or he's dying or something.
He may not die. He may get better.
I think he's dead. He's an old chap. I think the shock killed him. Otherwise, why haven't they produced him before now?
Oh, Johnny. They're going to put you in jail, aren't they?
I don't know.
But you didn't do anything. You tried to stop him.
I kept my mouth shut afterwards. What else could I do? He's my brother. If they believe my story, I'll get 2 or 3 years. If they don't... But they can't do anything to you. Not unless they find the gun.
I want them to.
It wouldn't help.
Oh, take me away from here, Johnny. I wouldn't be any trouble to you. We'd get along all right. At least we'd have something to remember afterwards.
We'd make a fine pair. Aren't you forgetting Dave?
I've told you Dave means nothing to me.
Well, he does to me. Doesn't anybody mean anything to you?
You do.
Till a better proposition comes along.
You can say what you like to me, but you can't change me. And you can't hurt me. I've no pride where you're concerned. And I don't give up easily. Remember, I come from a slum. From the gutter, where it's quite a step up even to the pavement. I never had a home. I never had a father my mother could put a name to. I never had a thing. Until one day I found that I was attractive to the opposite sex. I discovered my legs weren't made just to stand on. I had one talent. Most people haven't got any. So I used that talent. And I got tough. I never loved anyone until you came along. I was never unfaithful to anyone in my life. Because I never had anyone to be unfaithful to. Oh, Johnny, please believe me.
Can't you see it's no use?
Johnny, you're the only one.
Am I?
Kiss me.
Oh, what's the use? We're not nice people. We're in this room. And Ryan is watching like a cat with a mouse. Dave. Dave, believe me.
Don't bother to explain. You're two of a kind. Who's next on your list, Calico? Ryan? He's not married yet, or doesn't that matter?
That's enough.
Well, I'm congratulating you, Johnny. She'll stick to you through thick and thin for a week at least.
I said save it.
Go to the devil. Both of you.
Never mind, let him go.
He might do anything.
Dave!
Dave. Dave, listen to me. I'm sorry. Dave, don't go. That's your case.
Thank you, Mr. Manson. Well, miss? What's the matter with you? Are you ill? You look as if you'd seen a ghost.
Leave him alone. What do you want?
You, Johnny Mansell.
No, not him.
Don't say anything, Calico. Is this an arrest?
Good gracious, no. Inspector Harris would like to have a word with you down at the station, that's all.
What if I don't go?
You'll go, won't you?
Johnny, don't go, please.
Why don't you charge me?
Well, we will. But justice has to take its course. Now, let's have another go. You say on the Thursday in question, you went racing.
I've already told you 3 times. Why don't you ask Grant? I met him in the high street.
Yes, that's right. Outside the pawn shop. He told us you said you were getting your racing glasses out.
But it wasn't true, was it? Then you go home at 10 p.m. and went straight out again. Now, where did you go, Mr. Mansell?
I've told you.
Have you got that warrant? A search warrant. If we go back together, perhaps you can show us where you've hidden the money. After you, Mr. Mansell.
We found the old man, Danny. That's all we needed. It's all up now.
I don't believe you. You're just trying to trick me.
It's all up, I tell you.
Leave me alone.
We found the old man. The fellas that did it are in the bag.
Did you hear that, Calico?
Don't say anything, Dave. He's just trying to catch you out.
No, Calico, no, not this time. I found the old man. Danny, you remember him, Dave.
You're a liar, Ryan!
You haven't got any proof. You're just lying. He's outside that door.
I don't believe you!
It's him, all right. Recognize him anywhere. He's been haunting me. I did it, Ryan. I shot your father. It was me. But take him away. Take him away, for God's sake. Take him away. I killed him for the money. The money's been burnt, but take him away, for God's sake. Yes, Johnny. It's him.
Johnny.
Danny. In the presence of Inspector Harris here. Are these the 2 men who were in the foundry that night?
They are, Betty.
No! Dave, tell them how Johnny tried to stop you! Tell them! Tell them!
Calico.
All right.
Sir?
Johnny.
Danny, it's me, Paddy. Thanks for what you've done.
He's blind. Blind as a bat. Like I said, it was just blind man's bluff.
Ha
I'll be waiting.